Hello students, so till now we have discussed that how the reflection takes place from the plane mirror, right? And what actually happens in the plane mirror, right? Like it just changes the direction of the ray, isn't it? Now we'll talk about certain different kinds of mirror also. So there can be certain different mirrors, and I'll talk about the spherical mirror now. Now see, spherical mirror are actually little curved kind of mirrors, right? Plane mirrors are the plane mirror where we have studied the characteristics of the plane mirror, how the images are formed, how does the reflection takes place, which kind of image is formed, isn't it? Now the spherical mirrors are little, you know, curved mirrors, right? And we will draw, and you know, it will be very easy to understand. So it is just the beginning, and so it may take little time to understand, children. So spherical mirrors are curved mirrors. They are curved actually, and so they can also be known as curved mirrors, right? Now in the plane mirror, only the reflection takes place and the direction of the ray changes. But here in the spherical mirror, you know what can happen? Even light get converged, and some, is it visible? Right. And even diverge. Now these are two new terms which I have used over here. Now what is the meaning of converge and what is the meaning of diverge? Now see children, converge means what? Actually, when the different rays of light, okay, are coming, they come together. So bringing them together, coming the rays, when the rays come together, it is known as what? Converging. So converging can be like bringing, like different kind of, different rays actually, they are coming and they are meeting at one particular time. This is known as convergence, right? So different rays, they are coming from the different directions, right? But they are meeting at one place, that means they are getting converged, right? So spherical mirrors, we are talking about spherical mirrors are a little curved, and so they are also known as curved mirrors or spherical mirrors. Now the spherical mirrors, now we will be discussing about the types. But as I said, like plane mirrors only, what they do? They just change the direction of the parallel beams, right? Now here the spherical mirrors, what can happen with these kind of mirrors? They can converge the rays. That means the different direction, the rays which are coming from the different directions, they come and they meet at one place. Now what is the meaning of diverge? Just opposite of converging. That means rays, they are coming and getting scattered in different directions, right? So this is the, like the rays are coming and it is like ray comes and get scattered in different directions. So this will be known as what? Like we will say, like the rays are getting diverged. So divergence and convergence are the two new terms over here. Now so now we will be talking about the types of spherical mirrors, right? So actually spherical mirrors can be of two types, concave, or it can be also pronounced as concave, whatever you feel comfortable with. So concave and convex, right? Convex mirror and concave mirror. We are studying here now about the concave and convex mirrors. Now these mirrors are, you know, they are known as spherical mirrors. They are the, like the, when we talk about the types of the spherical mirrors, so we include concave and convex mirror in this. So now first of all, what is the meaning of spherical mirror? So if I want to write the definition, so it will come up in this way: a spherical mirror is that mirror. So it can be defined as, a spherical mirror is that mirror which or whose, So if you have to define spherical mirror, how can we define? A spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. Right? So a spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. Now this is just a definition. How to understand this? What is the meaning of this? So now we'll talk more about these two mirrors. Now see, when I talk about concave mirror, right? So how a concave mirror will be. So see children, this is a concave, see this I have drawn just a, you know, part of a sphere, isn't it? So a spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. First thing to understand, like this mirror is the part of a hollow sphere, right? This mirror is a part of a hollow sphere. Now I have just drawn this you know, curved surface. Till now it doesn't falls under any category, neither concave nor convex. Now what is the meaning of the concave mirror? Children, reflection, this, now this is the mirror, right? Now in mirror, one side is always, you know, coated with some silver lining. Silver lining is there, silver coating is there. So in concave mirror, what will happen, children? This surface here, where I'm drawing certain small oblique lines, isn't it? So this is a part which is covered by the silver coating. So what is there, children? Here silver coating is there. And this part is the reflecting surface. That means in the concave mirror, the reflection takes place, you know, takes place through the concave surface. In a concave mirror, the reflection takes place by the concave surface. Now, what is the meaning of concave? You can see this, I have drawn like this, isn't it? Now, this part is covered by some silver coating, and this is the bent part. Isn't it? This is a bent part. This is the concave part. Now the reflection takes place from this part, and so such kind of mirrors will be known as concave mirror. And definitely this is a part of the hollow sphere. How it is a part of the hollow sphere, children? If I draw it completely, so here it comes as the sphere. And the what we are saying in the definition also, spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface, now this here, this is a reflecting surface, I can even name it as A. This surface can be named as, you know, named as A. Which one? The reflecting surface. So I'll label it like this, reflecting surface. Right, this A part is reflecting surface and B part is silver coated. It is coated by silver, right? So reflection cannot take place by the silver coated surface. Definitely it will take by the opposite part. So reflection takes place by the, from the concave part, from the bent part, from the inward part. And so this kind of mirrors are known as concave mirror, right? So now this is the concave side. Here I will again, now here we will be talking about the convex mirror. So now again, a part of a hollow sphere, how does it, is it can be known as part of the hollow sphere. So if I make it like this, children, again it will, it is understood like it is a part of the hollow sphere. It is not drawn properly, but still right. So it is the part of the, right, it is the part of the hollow sphere. Now here, now the place where the silver coating was there, that was coated, you know, like here the oblique lines were drawn, isn't it? Here this part, the oblique lines are drawn because this is coated by silver, and the, from here the reflection do not takes place. Now first of all, now where this the reflection will takes place from this mirror. Now this will be this side, the bent part, the concave part will be coated by silver, isn't it? And it will be silver coating will be there. Now, the reflection will not take place from the concave part, from the inward part, from the bent part. Where the reflection will take place? From this bulging part, isn't it? See, you can see here I have coated, okay, or I can say I have drawn these oblique lines on the bulgy part. But here I am telling that the reflection takes place from this bulgy part, isn't it? And this inward part is coated with the silver, thing, and from here no reflection will takes place, right? So if I want to again write A and B, so as this one is A and this part is B, but here the B is reflecting surface, and this is the silver coating, right? Now, so what we are doing, what we are studying, we are talking about the spherical mirror, children. Spherical mirrors are curved. So you can see these are curved mirrors, isn't it? These are curved mirrors, and so they can also be known as curved mirrors. Now, these spherical mirrors can be of two types, concave and convex type. Now, what is the biggest difference when we see? So what will be the difference? Here the reflection takes place from the here. Reflection takes place from the concave or the bent part, right? Whereas here reflection takes place through bulging part. Right? Now, actually, see, when I talk about this sphere, okay, this sphere is I'm trying to show how this mirror is part of a sphere, okay, right? But now when we talk about, I'm trying to talk about certain new terms also, right? We'll be discussing, just now we have discussed about the two terms, converge and diverge, but still it is not proved, children, isn't it? How to prove? I'll be talking about that also, how these mirrors are known as, why these mirrors are known as converging or diverging mirror, because concave, concave mirror is known as converging mirror, right? It is known as converging mirror because it converges, and this one, it diverges. So how does, we need to prove, we need to talk about this, isn't it? So we'll be talking about this, but before discussing about this thing, we need to know about certain terms. What kind of terms, children? Certain new terms, center of curvature, principal axis, pole, aperture. So we just need to know about all these terms, then only we will be able to understand how actually the converge, the light rays get converged and how they are getting diverged, isn't it? So basically here, the first thing, the first aim was to make you people understand these mirrors are the part of hollow sphere, isn't it? If we talk about concave and we have drawn a circle sphere over here, this is also a part of the sphere, isn't it? This is a part of a sphere, and here also this mirror is a part of this sphere. Here the reflection takes place from this outward surface, isn't it? The reflection takes place from this outward surface, and this surface is not, right, from here, from this part the reflection will takes place, and here this one is the coated surface. This is the convex mirror. Now here this part, from the inner part, right, from the inner part, from this part the reflection takes place, and this part is the coated one, right? Now in concave mirrors, the reflecting surface is in front of the mirror, but here it is on the back side, it is on the bulging side, right? Now we'll talk about all these definitions, all these new terms radius of curvature and pole and all. Now see, first of all, when we have to define So I need to write also, there is no place written, so I'll have to clean it up. And again now we'll talk about new terms in continuation of this lecture only, right? So let's talk about certain new terms now. Now this is again, first of all we are talking about you know, all the new terms in the concave mirror. So this is my concave mirror. Right, this is my concave mirror. When it will become concave mirror? When this side will be shown as the polished surface. Right, now first of all, now what is this mirror? This mirror is a part of a sphere, isn't it? If I try to make a sphere, so this will be somewhat a sphere, isn't it? Now the center of the sphere, the center of this hollow sphere of which this mirror is a part, is known as center of curvature, children, right? So first of all, first thing is what? Center of curvature, right? Now what is the center of curvature? How can we define it? It is the center, okay, it is the center of the hollow glass sphere of which mirror is a part. Okay, so now see, this is a concave mirror, this is the reflecting surface, this is the polished surface, you know. Now if I try to make a complete sphere over here, now after making a sphere, if I try to take this you know, the point of the sphere, so this is a point, so this point is known as center of curvature, and it will be represented by C, right? It is represented by C. Now you know, second thing what I need to talk about is now pole, right? Pole is the center of the sphere, center of the mirror. Now pay attention that I am saying it is the pole is the center of the mirror. I am talking about this mirror only, this is mirror, this whole is sphere. The center of the sphere is center of curvature. The, you know, the middle part, the middle, or we can even say that this is the middle of the middle part of the mirror, and it is represented by P. So this is mirror, and if we talk about this center, so this will be the center, isn't it? And it has to be denoted by P, and P is what? It represents pole, isn't it? Now the third thing which we will talk about is the radius of curvature. Now what is the meaning of radius of curvature? See, whenever we talk about spheres, you know, in mathematics also, we know diameter. What is a diameter? Like the complete distance, this distance will be known as diameter, and half of this will be known as radius. See, here again we are, I'm emphasizing on this word, that we are talking about a sphere, and this mirror is a part of the sphere, isn't it? So the center point of the sphere is known as the center of curvature. Now this hole will be diameter. We are not bothered about the diameter. So this half part, this part, isn't it, this part will be known as what? This distance will be known as what? Radius of curvature. It will be known as radius of curvature. So if I want to define radius of curvature, so how it can be defined? Like the radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is the radius of the hollow sphere of the, you know, glass sphere of which the mirror is the part. So if I want to write a definition, so I'll be writing over here only, the difficult to write. The radius of curvature, right, the radius of curvature of a spherical glass sphere is the radius of the hollow glass sphere. Right, hollow glass sphere of which mirror is a part. Right, so this distance will be the radius of curvature, and definitely it will be represented by R. Right, now we'll talk about aperture. Right, what is the meaning of aperture? Now, aperture is the actual reflecting surface, right? This is the, see, from where the reflection will take place, the reflection will take place from this part, isn't it? The reflection will take place from this part, and so we can define this aperture as the portion of a mirror from which the reflection actually takes place. So, the portion of mirror from which reflection actually takes place now we'll talk about certain more. See, here we have written C. Okay, now we'll talk about the principal focus, right? Now, principal focus is a part, you know, it is the when it is lying somewhere in this this part only, right? Now, focus is a part when the ray of light, now I'll show you here, okay, this is our part. Now, one more thing before principal focus we'll need to talk about is principal axis. Students, we'll talk about principal axis before dealing with principal focus. We'll talk about principal axis. Now, principal axis is the line, you know, which joins the curvature and the pole. The line joining the C and P, okay, it is actually a perpendicular line which is drawn on the surface of the, like, you know, just we are imagining all this thing. So, how to define this? So, it will be the straight line which passes through the curvature and the pole. Right? So, this line will be known as principal axis. Now we'll talk about the principal focus, right? So now we'll be dealing about principal focus. Now, you know, this is the principal axis, this is the center of curvature, this P is the pole, okay? we'll definitely revise all this thing. Now this line which joins center of curvature and pole, this is known as principal axis. Now children, whenever the ray of light which is parallel, okay, the ray of light which is parallel to this principal axis, okay, it after reflection, you know, it will turn back to a particular point, and this point is known as principal focus. I'm talking about the, now the parallel rays which after reflection, which after reflection from this point, it turns up to a particular point which is known as focus. So a principal focus can be defined as the point where the rays meet after reflection. Now here remember, we are talking everything about the concave mirror, right? So here when the ray of light, when it passes, when it travels parallel to the principal axis, it get reflected from this point and it will turn back, and it will come back, all these will meet to a point which is known as focus. Now the focus is, you know, the this distance is, like when we talk about the curvature, this is, suppose if it is 10 centimeter, so the focus will be the 5 centimeter. So focus is, you know, like what, half of the center of curvature. And what is center of curvature? It is, center of curvature is the double of focus, right? So C will be equal to, like what, center of curvature will be equal to 2F. Okay, so now what is principal focus? The point where the rays meet after reflection. Now we'll talk about the next new term, and this will be the focal length. Now what is the meaning of focal length, children? The distance between, you know, this distance, the distance between the F and P, the distance between the F and P, the focus and the pole, will be known as the focal length. So focal length, it is the distance between the pole and focus. Now principal focus can be represented as F, and this will be represented as this small f, right? So here are all the new terms which we have studied. Now first of all, we have studied in the concave mirror. Concave, that means this, the reflection takes place from the inner bend, right? And this part is the reflecting surface, right? Now actually in this part, first of all, we have studied about the center of curvature. Now again I'm telling this thing, like this, these all mirrors are the, like curved mirrors, the concave and the convex mirror is the, you know, these two mirrors are the part of the hollow sphere. Now if I draw a sphere and if I take the center of the sphere will be known as the center of the curvature, which I have written over here. Like what is center of curvature? It is the center of the hollow sphere of which this mirror is a part. So this is a whole sphere. Now this mirror is a part of this hollow sphere, and the center of this is known as center of curvature. Now the second is radius. Now what is the radius of a sphere? It is the half of the diameter actually. And this center point shows, like center means what? It is half this way and half this way. So the distance from C till this point is known as radius of curvature. It will be denoted by R. Now what is the meaning of pole? Pole is represented by P, and the center, the middle part of this mirror, okay, the center or the middle part of this mirror. Again remember, now I'm not talking of this sphere, I'm talking only about this reflecting surface, this pole. The middle part of this reflecting surface, the middle part of this mirror is known as pole. It is represented by P. Now after this radius of curvature, we have done the aperture. Aperture is what, actually from where the reflection takes place, the reflecting part of a mirror. Okay, how to define the portion of mirror from which reflection actually takes place is known as the aperture. Now principal axis, what is the principal axis? When I join all these points, okay, when I join center of curvature, focus and pole. Actually, the line which passes through the center of curvature to the pole, the line joining the center of curvature and the pole which passes through these points is known as the principal axis, right? Now, after this, the two more are there, two more terms are there, principal focus and focal length. Now, what is principal focus, children? When the, see, principal axis, this is the principal axis, right? This is the principal axis. I can extend it till here. I can name it also. It can be named as X and Y. Okay, XY is the principal axis. Now, this is the center of curvature. Now, any ray which goes parallel, any ray which goes parallel to this principal axis will, I'm talking only in concave mirror now at present, it is going to pass through one particular point, and this point is known as focus. It is represented by F. Now, actually F is, you know what, the half of the center of curvature actually, right? Now, when the, how can we define it now? The principal focus is a point where the rays meet after reflection, because the rays, all the rays will, you know, it will meet at this particular point after reflection. Remember, after reflection, the point at which the rays meet after reflection, I am talking about the concave mirror. Okay, and which ray? Not every ray, children. Okay, do not get confused. When a, you know, when we are talking about the principal axis, when a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, it get reflected and you know, it meet at a, it get converge actually, I should say, it get converge at a point. So the point where these rays are getting converged will be known as what? Principal focus. Now, focal length, the distance between the focus, the principal focus and the pole of a concave mirror. Okay, the distance between the focus, principal focus and the pole of the concave mirror is known as the what? Focal length, right? Now, this all new terms we have discussed in the concave mirror. Now, we'll be talking about the same terms in the convex mirror also. So, now first of all, we need to talk about, like, this is our convex mirror. And in this convex mirror, the this part will have the oblique lines, and here the reflection takes place from this part, isn't it? Now, when I say pole, so again, where is the pole? The half part of this mirror, the middle part of this mirror, so this is P, okay? Center of curvature, so again, I'll draw this as a sphere. And the center point of this is this, so this will be center of curvature. One very important point, you know, we'll talk about the differences also. Now, radius of curvature, so again, this total part will be known as radius of curvature, and it will be represented by what? R. So this is center of curvature. Because when we make a sphere, this part, this point comes as the center of the sphere. This P is the pole, R is the radius of curvature. This part, this side part, bulgy part from where the reflection takes place will be known as aperture, right? Now, after this, the focus, I am talking about now focus. So, this point, because after reflection, you know, now very important thing to understand in the convex mirror, here in concave mirror, the real focus is there, children. Real focus is present, right? What is the meaning of real focus? That light rays, when they are parallel to principal axis, when they travel, they get reflected and they really pass through a point, which is they meet at point, they get converged at one point, which is known as focus, right? One very important point over here, that in convex mirror, when the ray of light will travel, okay, parallel to the principal axis. Now, where is principal axis, children? This X and this Y will be the principal axis, okay? In this part, the center of curvature is not, you know, it is not in front of the mirror. Here, the center of curvature is at the back side of the mirror, of the convex I am talking about now. This is convex mirror. And this is the concave mirror. Here the center of curvature is in front of the mirror. There the center of curvature is not in front of the mirror. It is not in front of the mirror. It is at the back side. Right? Now. So, now when the ray of light, this is principal axis, this is center of curvature, this is pole. Now, when the ray of light travel, okay, these ray, they are parallel to principal axis, they won't go that side, isn't it? Because why? Because it has a reflecting surface, so it cannot go, okay, it will get reflected, okay, and it get diverged actually, the ray, okay, here. In concave mirror, we have studied like how they are meeting at one point, and so they are known as converging mirror, isn't it? The ray of, this is principal axis. When a ray of light comes, which is, you know, parallel to principal axis, it get reflected from this point, and it get, you know, these all rays are converging, meeting at one particular point. They're, what actually converge means, you know, coming close. Okay, the rays are coming close. And what is the meaning of diverge, children? Diverge means spread out. Okay, diverge means what, children? Spreading out. So here the rays are, all the rays are coming close. They are meeting. They are coming at one point. So that is the reason it is known as converging mirror. And it has got real focus because in reality, the light rays, they are meeting at one particular, they are getting converged at one particular point. Now, here, when the parallel rays, you know, they come, they get reflected and they move apart. But when they are, you know, when we try to extend it backward, it meet at point F. And this F will be the principal focus for the convex mirror, but it do not have, like what I am trying to say, like it has got real focus, it do not have. But because the person who will be seeing the rays from this side, it will just appear that these rays are coming from this side, but actually this is not happening. So it do not have real focus, right? So this is how here we have discussed about the difference between the concave and convex, you know, how, like, why this one is known as converging mirror and why this one is known as diverging mirror. Because whenever a ray of light is coming, okay, whenever ray of light is coming, it is getting reflected because, it is getting spread, it is moving out, it's moving apart, right? It is not meeting at one particular point. Then when we meet it, you know, when we try to extend it backwards, then it comes and meet at one point. So in reality, these all rays are not meeting, right? So it do not have, we cannot say like it has got real focus. So that is the reason why these are known as, the convex mirrors are known as diverging mirrors, and this one is known as converging mirrors. Because here when the ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, when it get reflected, then it it converged at one point, and here they diverged, right? So here also in convex mirror we have studied all the new terms, like this we will make a sphere, C will be the center of the sphere, and so it will be known as center of curvature. This distance will be known as radius of curvature, right? Then the middle part of this reflecting surface will be known as pole. Here the center of curvature is not in front of the mirror, whereas here the center of curvature is in front of the mirror, right? Then this line joining, again the center of curvature and focus and the pole, you know, this line will be known as principal axis. There also we have seen the principal axis, right? Now focal length, again this distance will be known as what? The focal length, right? Distance between the pole and the focus will be known as the focal length. And again this point, which is the half of the center of curvature, will be known as the focus. So these all are the new terms which we have studied in the convex and the concave mirror. Now we'll move to the next topic.